Mangere, South Auckland, a march to remember the fallen soldiers of yesteryear.
For many years, we'd go to Anzac, we'd sit on TV, people talk about it, but we never knew that we had a connection. We knew that our people played a part so that, you know, this celebration of Cook Islands means that we can say we too can stand on days like this of commemoration.
Well, the Anzac is a commemoration over in Australia and all over Aotearoa. Today's commemoration is for those 500 Cook Islanders who served in the First World War.
Young Cook Islanders responded to the call for service at the outbreak of war. Many were recruited as reinforcements for the Māori Pioneer Battalion in Egypt, France and Palestine.
It's very surprising because they were kind of my age. Like most of them, the volunteers were my age. And for them to be doing things that are very dangerous that adults are supposed to do, I guess, it's very scary.
A remarkable service and sacrifice still remembered more than 100 years later.
Anzac Day is a time to renew the bonds of friendship forged in hardship and to celebrate the camaraderie which never dies. As commemorations have grown and evolved, we recognise all our Pacific Island soldiers who continue to serve proudly across the ranks of our defence forces.
One of the smallest territories in the Pacific, Niue, also enlisted 150 soldiers to fight in the Great War.
Some of the soldiers, they ran away from home to join. They haven't got the consent from their parents, but that's how they feel. They wanted to go with whoever that make the call. And so that's why the number was 150.
After training in New Zealand, 126 of them were dispatched to Egypt, and about half were sent to France the following year to serve with the Pioneer Battalion.
I have uncles who went to war. So I guess, you know, I'm proud of them to take the family name.
Unable to adapt to the harsh wintry conditions overseas, more than 80% were hospitalised, while 15 died of diseases and were buried in France, England or at sea. It's that bravery that is commemorated today.
Look at us today. Without them, there's no peace. Look at us. We have to cherish all the memories of our forefathers have gone to war because they have no choice at all, but they've just been asked to join in and go into war.
More than 90 Tongan soldiers volunteered to fight in World War I, and this community service in Mangere honours them and those who continue to serve.
There's plenty of Tongan personnel within the Defence Force, but, you know, it's just getting the message out there that, you know, a lot of them serve from South Auckland, so it's just growing this and just keeping this initiative going and just creating that conversation so that they understand, you know, Tonga did play a part in these world wars with providing that peace and stability for where we are now.
The Royal New Zealand Navy's first Tongan warrant officer inspiring the next generation.
I feel happy I came here because this is my community. I grew up around here. I just want to show them that these sailors in the Navy, they are Tongan. They grew up here as well.
Definitely grateful for those who fought for us in days, times gone by. And definitely for our younger generation, you know, there is a space for you in the military to serve and to work with your community. And you're definitely welcome with open arms.
It's that courage that many pay tribute to all over the world, so that we will always remember them.
We often have that statement, that saying, you know, standing on the shoulders of giants. What does that actually mean? Well, I believe that days like today means that we can look, we can see the service and the sacrifice of what it meant. And so standing on their shoulders is to say that now let's pursue the greatness of who we are as an individual, as a community, and as a people.